Hey guys, welcome to Math Class with Ms. Brown. Before we get started with today's lesson, make sure you guys subscribe to this channel for more fun math videos. And make sure you guys like this video and share it with your family and friends. Now let's get started with today's lesson. So today you guys are going to be learning how to multiply using the standard algorithm. In front of you, you have your criteria for success. And it says, make sure digits are lined up by place value. Start with the digits at the bottom. Start in the ones place. Multiply the digit at the bottom with every digit at the top, starting from the ones place and on. Place answers below the line bar and carry over when needed. I know that sounds like a lot, but let me show you guys a few examples. Okay, so in front of you, you have three problems. Let's start with the first one. We have 52 times 3. Now, our CFS on the top says, make sure the digits are lined up by place value. And as you can see, we have the ones place and we have the tens place, right? So you got to make sure they are lined up, right? And then it says start with the digits at the bottom, right? So we only have one digit at the bottom and we see a 3. That's the only one. Start in the ones place. Well, the 3 is in the ones place and is at the bottom, so we're going to start with that. So it says multiply the digit at the bottom with every digit at the top, starting from the ones place and on, right? So we see that we have a 3, so we're going to multiply that by the 2, right? 3 times 2, right? And then we're going to do 3 times 5, right? So now let's do it. 3 times 2 is 6. So we're going to put our 6 right here in the ones place. So yeah, we did 3 times 2, which is 6. So we're done with the 2. So we're going to cross the 2 out because we don't need it anymore because we already multiplied the 3 by the 2. So next we're going to do the 3 times the 5, which is 15. So we're going to put the 15 right underneath it. And that's it. That's it. So the 6 belongs to the 3 times 2, and then the 15 belongs to the 3 times 5, right? And that's it, guys. Wasn't that easy? Okay, so let's look at the next one. So we have 63 times 24. So now we have a 2-digit by a 2-digit. Before, we just had a 2-digit by a 1-digit, but we have 2-digit by 2-digit. So I know it's going to take a lot of more work, but let's just do step by step. So we have our digits lined up by place value, right? And then we're going to start with the digits at the bottom. So the first one we're going to start with is the 4 because it is in the ones place. It says multiply the digit at the bottom with every digit at the top, starting from the ones place and on. So we have 4 times 3, right? We're going to take that 4 and multiply it by the 3. 4 times 3 is 12. Yep, 4 times 3 is 12. So we're going to take that 2 because it's in a ones place, and we're going to place it underneath the line bar in the ones place, right? And then we're going to take that 1 and we're going to carry it over to the tens place, right? So now we have to ask ourselves, okay, so 4 times 3 is 12, right? You put the 2 at the bottom, carry the 1. So now you got to say, okay, what is 4 times the 6, right? And remember, that 1 that we carried over at the top, we have to add that to our final answer. So 4 times 6 is 24, and we have to add that 1, and that's how we get 25. So now we are done with the 4. We're going to cross it out. So now we have to move to the next digit at the bottom, which is the 2 in the tens place. So we're going to do exactly what we did with the 4, multiply by every digit at the top. We're going to do the same thing with the 2. We're going to take that 2 and multiply by every digit at the top, right? So being that the 2 is in the tens place, we have to start our answer in the tens place in this second row. So that's why we have to put a placeholder in the ones place, because that 2 that we are working with now is in the tens place. So we're no longer working in the ones place when it comes to our answer at the bottom. So that's why you automatically put a placeholder there. So we have 2 times 3, which is 6. So we're going to put the 6 down there, right? So next, we got to think about, okay, what is 2 times 6? And 2 times 6 is 12. So we're going to put the 12 there, right? So now we're going to add the numbers up, right? We're going to add them up. So 2 plus 0 is 2. And then 5 plus 6 is 11. Put the 1 down there. Carry the other 1 over. Then we have 2 plus 2, which is 4, plus the 1, which is 5. And then we have 1 plus nothing, which is 1. So our total answer is 1,512. I know you can't see it, so I'm going to rewrite it right here. So we have 1,512. And that is our final answer. I know this is a lot. I know. But the more you practice, the more familiar it will become. So let's look at the next one. We have 245 times 32. Now this is a 3-digit by a 2-digit, right? So we're gonna make sure our digits are lined up by place value. We're gonna start with the first digit on the bottom in the ones place, which is the 2. So we're gonna ask ourselves, what is 2 times 5? And 2 times 5 is 10. We're gonna take that 0, put it at the bottom, bring that 1 over, and put it in the next place value, which is the tens place, right? So now we're gonna take that 2, and we're gonna also multiply it by the 4. And then we're going to add the 1, right? So 4 times 2 times the 4 is 8 plus the 1, which is 9. So now 9 is just a 1-digit number. You keep it there. So now we do 2 times the 2, which is 4. And that's how we got our 4. So we're done with the 2. So when we're done with that 2, we're just going to cross out that 1 that was at the top because we no longer need it. So now we've moved on to the 3. The 3 is the next digit at the bottom, and you have to multiply that digit by every digit at the top, just like we did the 2. Always remember to put your placeholder because that 3 that we're working with now is in a tens place. So our answer has to start in the tens place. So that's why you put your placeholder. Okay, I hope that makes sense. So the 3 times the 5 is 15, right? So you put the 5 there, okay? And then that 1, you carry over there to the next door neighbor. So now you take the 3 and you multiply it by the 4, which is 12, right? And then you got to add that 1, which is 13. So you put the 3 down there, and then you carry that 1 over to the next place value. So now we have 3 times 2, which is 6, plus the 7, plus the 1, I'm sorry, which is 7. 3 times 2, which is 6, plus the 1, which is 7. Yes. So now we're going to add 0 plus 0, 0. 9 plus 5 is 14. Put the 4, carry the 1. And then 4 plus 3, which is 7, plus the 1, which is 8. And then 7 plus 9, which is 7. So our final answer is 7,840. Okay, I know that was a lot, but let's practice some more. Okay, so this is what I want you guys to do. Pause this video. Get your paper and pencil and try these 3 problems on your own, and then when you're done, we will go over them together. Okay, you guys should be done. So let's take a look. We have 27 times 2, right? We're going to follow the steps that we see on the board, our CFS. The digits are lined up by place value, and we're going to start at the bottom, right? And we're going to take that bottom digit, and we're going to multiply it by every digit at the top, right? So this one is pretty easy. So it's just 1 digit at the bottom, 2 digits at the top. So the 2 times the 7 is 14. That's why you put the 4 down at the bottom, and you carry the 1. And then now we have 2 times 2, which is 4, plus the 1, which is 5. And that's how you get 54. So easy. Let's go to the next one. So 83 times 25. We're going to start with the 5 at the bottom in the ones place. We're going to multiply by every digit at the top. Now, 5 times 3 is 15. Put your 5 at the bottom. Carry your 1. So now we're going to take that 5 and multiply it by the 8. 5 times 8 is 40, plus the 1, which is 41. So now that we are done multiplying the 5 by every digit at the top, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to add our placeholder at the bottom for the second row, right? But first, let's erase these arrows and the 1 at the top because we don't need them anymore because we already used those for the 5. So now we're on to the 2. The 2 is in the tens place. So that's why our answer will start in the tens place. So that's why we have our placeholder. So we're going to take that 2 and multiply by every digit at the top, right? So first, we're going to do the 2 times the 3, which is 6. So I'm going to put my 6 there. It starts. We put our 6 in the tens place because the 2 is in the tens place. And then 2 times 8, which is 16. And that's it. We're going to add it all up together. Right? So we have 5 plus 0, which is 5. Then we have 1 plus 6, which is 7. Then we have 4 plus 6, which is 10. Put your 0, carry to 1. And then now we got 1 plus 1, which is 2. And our final answer is 2,075. Did you guys get that right? All right. I know you guys are getting better. I know you must feel excited. So let's go on to this 3-digit by 2-digit. Oh my God, so much work. But come on, let's do it. So we have 535 times 56. So we're going to take that first digit at the bottom in the ones place, which is the 6. And remember, we're going to just take it and multiply by every digit at the top. So 6 times the 4, which is 24, we put our 4, we carry the 2. So then 6 times 3, which is 18, plus the 2, which is 20, we put the 0 down there, carry the 2. And then 6 times 5, which is 30, plus the 2, which is 32. I know we're moving fast, but if you just watch what I'm doing step by step, it should become much more easier. So we're done with that 6. We crossed the 6 out and the 2's at the top. We put our placeholder at the bottom. So now we are moving on to the 5. Okay, so we're going to multiply the 5 by every digit at the top. 5 times 4 is 20. You put the 0 down, put the 2 at the top. And then 5 times 3, which is 15. 15 plus the 2 at the top, which is 17. Put the 7 at the bottom, carry the 1. And then 5 times 5, which is 25, plus the 1, which is 26. So now we're going to add it all up. 4 plus 0 is 4. 0 plus 0 is 0. 2 plus 7 is 9. And 3 plus 6 is 9. And 2 plus nothing is 2. Our final answer is 29,904. And there you go. There you have it. Good job. Good job if you guys got this all right. But if you did it, it is okay. The more practice, the better. Okay, that's the end of today's lesson. You guys did amazing. Remember, it's going to take more practice. But before you go, make sure you subscribe to this channel, like this video, and share this video with your classmates and your family and friends if they need help in math. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Miss Brown_the_math_teacher and on TikTok at Miss Brown the math teacher. I'll see you guys in the next class. Bye.